Check one. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Spring 2022 Graphic Design and Video Portfolio and Best in Show Awards. We're going to do a quick test because we are now live on YouTube. So we're just checking out the audio right now. There's about a 45-second delay. So as soon as I hear back from one of our marketing people, I will shut up. So. Check one, two. You don't have to take your seats. We got a few minutes before the awards. Check one, two. Check one, two. And that wraps up for me.
want to welcome everyone to the spring karaoke event. I don't know if you guys knew this, but everyone volunteered by walking in the door to sing some songs.
I didn't realize that was that sensitive. Arrows to move the slide on this. What's that? Arrows to move the slide.
I think so, yeah.
All right, we'll guess.
Go ahead and poke one and see.
Well, as long as we don't get the other way. If I click down below, I see it. We're good. Where's the music at, Nick? You don't like that background? That's a toe tapping. You might hit X.
What is that on this? Down here?
Yep.
Okay, goodbye, Stan Getz.
No PowerPoint. All right. Thank you, sir. Down at the bottom. There are the arrows at the bottom there, sir.
Keyboard not working?
Nope. No, keyboard didn't work. All right, I got to get serious because I can turn into a roll ham up here in front of people. And I'm sure the students have probably shared some fantastic stories about me rambling and having long, crazy conversations. But seriously, I want to welcome everyone. This is pretty exciting. I mean, it's exciting for me because we're back in the gallery. see people's faces. This is a great event, and everyone should be excited. I want to tell you, everyone, before we get started, that usually every time we kick off this event, I do something like out of the ordinary, we'll call it. I usually do something real kind of extreme, and it seems really funny to me. One time for the spring event, I dressed up as a bee, and when they introduced me, I ran around the room like a bee. Everyone, of course, got a great laugh out of that, adults included. One time, we all dressed up like we did wrestlers. We did studio wrestling. That was really entertaining. I won the belt, so I was the PTC heavyweight champion. One time, Superman. We did a Superman thing where I ripped the shirt off, Superman cape and stuff. So, but anyways, I thought this time, since I better fly a little under the radar, since we're just kind of, I just wanted to ease back into things. I didn't want everyone to come into the room and sit down and see some crazy guy in a bee suit go running around the room, and then everyone look at each other and think, like, who's this guy that we let instruct our children? So, because I think if it was Emily may have asked me if I was dressing up as a bee. So I don't know where that came from. Maybe Miss Cirillo probably informed you. Yeah, it could have been a lobster. There was a lot of things that have done historically. So I apologize for not coming in the room and running around like a crazy person, but again, I just felt like it might be better to have a little bit more of a controlled environment. Welcome. I do appreciate everyone being here. I want to welcome everyone to the Spring 2022 Portfolio Show, Best of Show. This is a really, you know, kind of special time for all the students here. It's, where they're able to display and show the work that they've been accumulating and the skills that they've been harnessing and developing for nearly 2 years. I know that they should feel extremely proud of themselves. If this group has taught me personally anything, it's just that, you know, when we started, I remember the very first class for the graphic students, they were the first time that I had to teach compositional drawing in a remote virtual environment. And I remember seeing that class show up on my schedule, and I kept thinking, like, how am I going to teach drawing to students that are far away via the computer? But we did it successfully. But I really want this group of students really has shown some accountability and persistence and the ability to adapt. They transitioned really well whenever we went from that virtual environment to coming on campus. They didn't miss a beat. little smaller in size, but there's a lot of talent in this room, and they should feel very proud of themselves. So proud of you guys. Give yourselves a little round of applause, if you would. So let's kick this thing off, otherwise I'll be up here forever. So my name is Sean Moody. As you don't know me, and if your son or daughter hasn't told you who I am, I'm the graphic design portfolio instructor. And this is the part of the portfolio show where we recognize the students for their excellent work in building their portfolios, samples, and preparing for the show. We call it the Best of Show Awards. Before we move too far, I'm just going to explain the process a little bit. So a few weeks ago, we asked a panel of judges to evaluate the student work. The students in the portfolio class have to submit their single best campaign work, and it's down to one to two categories for tonight, and that's graphic design and video production. And the judges juried their work. I guess I better move the slides a little bit so that we're all on the same page. There we go. There we go, good. And the categories we're gonna have are second runner-up, first runner-up, and best of show, okay? So again, in the judging process, and I'm sure Mr. Cimini will emphasize the same thing, is very challenging for the judges because there's a lot of good work that they have to evaluate. It's not a very quick solution. They have to really take into consideration all of the pieces that have been submitted by that particular student, and they have to go through, it's an evaluation process. They're looking at the validity of the work, how authentic is it, how original is it, and, whether or not it relates directly to the industry that they've created the pieces for, and, their personal observations and their assessment of it is, their belief in how successful the pieces would be. The students are probably so tired of me saying things like synergy and making sure that all of your portfolio pieces are connected and that they possess, they communicate with each other and that they drive some sort of behavioral response to its intended audience. So, the judges have their work cut out for them. Oh, before we move too far, definitely need to kind of talk about your primary portfolio instructors. One, that would be me. And two, Mr. Brian Cimini. Thank you. I can give you guys about 5-10 minutes if you want to keep clapping. So the dedication and the diligence of the primary portfolio instructors, the portfolio class is a very stressful endeavor. Teaching a portfolio class is equally demanding. I'm sure Cimini would agree with me on that, and the students could probably echo the same thing. It's a constant feedback loop, a little bit of an OODA loop. They're submitting things, asking for feedback, and we're kind of embraced in that process of critical thinking to determine the effectiveness of the work that they're submitting. So it's challenging for both parties, but fun. I would never take. I have no regrets about any of it. Also, some additional special appreciation for Emily Flick. She designed all of the promotional designs for the show. So when you're looking at the visual components and you walked in the door, you saw the program, you saw the graphic that was displayed up on the slides, the social media advertisements, the banner that's up on the website, that's her concept. I guide her, I suppose, would be the best way, but it's important for the show to have student representation, so just want to thank her for taking the time. There may have been a few emails that she was probably thinking to herself, Moody, really? Like that? You want me to move that far? So, but greatly appreciated. Thank you. Additional special appreciation, Mr. Frank Scherter. I think Frank is not here. He had to leave because he has a collaborate class this evening. But Mr. Scherter manages and handles the portfolio website. The students' work will also be displayed. They have an intro video and a link to their personal website that they've been working on. This website's been very effective and very powerful for us from a career services standpoint, and an additional way for the students to continue to promote their skills and their work. So I just want to thank Frank for taking that particular task on. I'd like to also thank Mr. Eric Joseph. He's in the back. He was the guy in the blue shirt that was up here. Mr. Joseph is extremely valuable in setting up the what you see behind the scenes, I would like to refer to it as, handling all of the sound and the lights and, you know, instructing the students as part of their learning process. So it's a big task to take on, and he allocates a lot of his time and effort towards it. Thank you, Mr. Joseph. And where's my little arrows at? There we are. And then finally, Miss Alicia Cirillo. Miss Cirillo is not here this evening as well, but Miss Cirillo is, you know, my colleague, and we sit side by side. We have a lot of laughs, and typically as I'm instructing the students for portfolio class, she has them for portfolio web. So she's the primary web instructor and responsible for their web skills and their web development. So really like to thank her for the efforts that she puts forward for the students as well. Got to flip my sheet. So funny joke real quick before we get started. I was talking to some people in here, and yesterday we had a really odd conversation in my class, which we typically do. For some reason, the students got on the topic of discussion about their fathers and the various number of reader glasses that they had. So I'm just observing and listening to this conversation go on, and just random, I wouldn't call them complaints, but they were just more or less kind of joking about their fathers and the multiple pairs of readers that were lying around the house, or the click ones on the front and all these things. And out of nowhere, Emily says, "Mr. Moody, do you wear glasses?" And I said, "Well, I have glasses. They're in my truck right now. My eyesight's not that poor that I need them all the time, but I do wear them at night in my truck when I'm driving, and specifically when it's raining." Out of nowhere, Thomas Heckworth laughs like it's insane, like that was the most isolated situation ever. And I start laughing, and I'm thinking, like, what's going on here? Why is this such a big deal that I have to wear glasses only while it's at night and while it's raining? I guess that's very specific. And I guess that automatically threw me into the category of being a parental unit as well. I don't know. I just automatically fell into your you know, parents' age classification. So anyways, it's very funny. And just so that you know, back there, I have to make the print really big on my sheet so that I can see what it is that I'm saying. So kind of back at you with the glasses thing. All right. So graphic design. Our second runner-up for this evening is Emily Flick.
Come on down.
Come on down, Em. So Emily designed and produced a multi-channel campaign for Burchett Construction. And we're going to take a look at some of the work, and we're going to read some of the judges' comments about Emily's work. So this is a magazine ad. So there were four components to this campaign, and being multi-channel, meaning that she created a campaign that would be simultaneously or timed, it just depends on the marketing efforts, to be displayed in multiple areas. So there was a magazine advertisement, there was a billboard, there was an 8-page informational booklet, and a direct mail postcard. So, again, when I say the things that they're probably tired of hearing me say about, like, synergistic engagement with the pieces communicating to one another, all right, Moody, we get it, we understand. So magazine ad, the billboard, direct mail postcard, and then the 8-page booklet, cover, inside pages here. It was very well done. So some of the feedback from the judges. The first is more of a comment. It said that many people might not consider that a construction company relies on professional marketing representation to increase the financial growth and assist in securing future contracts. The clean, sharp colors, rich contrast combined to showcase the campaign pieces and promote industry validity. The organization of the content provides a feeling of a company with a strong reputation and is well respected within their industry. So I couldn't agree more. I know Joe Burchak personally. He's a good friend of mine, and I haven't shown this to him yet, but I'm inclined to probably show it to him. I know he would be impressed with this as well. So congrats. First runner-up, excuse me, Gabriel Tranchitella. Come on down, Gabby. You know, are you all right?
Yeah.
Okay. You'll be fine. All right, so let's take a look, talk about Gabby's work here. So. Gabby developed a product promotional campaign centered around the music industry for a band. And here are some of the comments the judges made about Gabby's work. So, Pierce the Veil, that's product promotion. So, the entire campaign demonstrates a great deal of work, a sense of detail and commitment, and it's very comprehensive. It's an excellent way to blend traditional artistic skills and merge them into digital and commercial design. Before I move any further, I do want to note that like all the drawing and everything that you're seeing up here is all Gabby's hand illustration work, so that's a major task, so it should be really well recognized. There is no doubt that you're trying to promote the band, and it works. Illustration work is fantastic and very skillful. The pieces fit the industry and the market very well. So take a look at some of the work. And I think it was ended up being a 28-page booklet that we did. So 28-page booklet, a lot of illustration work, color application. The type fits the subject matter extremely well. So congratulations. Best of show for spring 2022, Thomas Heckworth. Come on down. So, Thomas developed a multifaceted campaign for Helicon Brewing, which is located right here in Oakdale. I've never been there, but when he said, can I do a brewery, I said yes. So, here are some of the comments that the judges made about Thomas's. So Helicon Brewing, highly cohesive design and color scheme. It all works well together and is consistently applied across all elements. Nice vector illustration, simplicity of the designs and the use of color are spot on. It's not overdone. Clean, meticulous layouts of the responsive landing page. It's very symbolic of the industry and realistic. And the elements tied together nicely. It's clear a lot of work was done with this campaign, very well done. So this is a beverage, the growler label, I believe, so there's a growler on the table. Yeah, there was a lot of effort put into all of these. And again, the part that I want to focus on and emphasize a lot is that all of the work by all of the students, but specifically these the three that you're seeing tonight, the pieces all connect to the target audience or the end user, or advertise and promote to them on multiple levels. Simple things of like the utilization of a QR code that if scanned with your phone could potentially take you to the landing page where you would fill out additional information, where they're going to collect content, and you know Helicon's going to increase their database or their contacts, and then from there they can you know advertise and market to you further via email or send out promotional social media things. So congratulations. That's it for me. You guys are probably super happy that I'm getting off the stage. Well, I'm just sliding down the stage. So I would like to turn it over to Mr. Cimini, the instructor for the video production. Thank you.
Okay, everybody, how we doing? Having fun? Just flew in from out of town, and boy, my arms. I'd like to, again, thank everybody for coming out to the show tonight, and I'd like a humongous thank you to all of our students for working so hard this quarter, and for all of these students in the sixth quarter class who are back there. One of them is actually a second quarter student, so they're out here spending some time live streaming this to the internet, having a good time. So at this point, next quarter, this is going to be you, so get ready. But talk a little bit about the hurdles that our video students have overcome throughout this quarter between scheduling conflicts, finding actors, writing, producing, actually going out on these video shoots. It's been tough, but they created some awesome work that I think they should be proud of, and we're going to take a look at our second runner-up, who created a really fun piece, Crystal Luchart. See, she was like terrified she was gonna have to walk on stage at some point. She's like, oh, I hope I don't win. Too bad. Crystal created a Nintendo Switch commercial for the Switch Lite game console, which I own one myself, so it's pretty fun. And we're gonna take a little look-see at that commercial right now. I hope this works. Oh no, go away, Microsoft Edge. Does not work. Come on. Yeah, confirming. Continue. There we go. Hello, check one. There we go. The Switch commercial was shot from, you produce this at home for the most part?
My church.
Your church. Awesome. Camera work, lighting, audio design, sound design, motion graphics. There's a ton of stuff that goes into these things, and it came out really good.
Nintendo Switch Lite. With 32 gigabytes internal storage. Nintendo Switch Lite. With 32 gigabytes internal storage, expandable storage via micro SD. All you need in one device. Thousands of games available. Comes in multiple colors and designs. Utilizes wireless controllers. Nintendo Switch Lite. Only $199.99. Nintendo Switch Lite. With 32 gigabytes internal storage, expandable storage via micro SD. All you need in one device. Thousands of games available. Comes in multiple colors and designs. Utilizes wireless controllers. Nintendo Switch.
Complete advertisement from start to finish, and the judges liked it. Let's see what their comments were. The piece is complete from start to finish. It's a YouTube notification. From a the recreation of the iconic Nintendo click in the beginning, and showing some actual gameplay and screen grabs, wrapping up in the end with a nice price tag. The moving shots across the console and the games are effective to showcase the item and how they look, and wow, you have a lot of games. Are those all your games?
Yes, I bought more after.
It's a lot of games, you got more than me. All right, so that was our Nintendo Switch commercial for Crystal. Well-deserved little trophy there. Probably going to play it on the way home. Get some shots of Ethan. All right. Now we got to play the balancing of the audio game now. Let's
see. I've wanted to say this for a while.
So that was our Nintendo Switch Lite commercial. The next one, our first runner-up in the video production portfolio, is Shelby Higgs. Shelby has crafted for us a spoken word visual poem. So writing a poem and then sort of filming it to play like a short film. Had a lot of really awesome camera movements and a good story. Yeah, he can stand there. All right, so here is the visual spoken word poem, Ghosted.
I've wanted to say this for a while, and maybe it's just liquid courage. I don't know. You're so beautiful. Like, really. I think you're so gorgeous.
Calling me beautiful through drunken videos, pleading why we could be great together. Yet, we hadn't actually met. You barely knew me. We only talked for a few weeks, and eventually I grew the courage to see you in person. I warned you about my fears with men because of mistreatment in the past. You assured me you weren't like that. And you weren't. Not in that way, at least. We talked for 2 hours straight about anything that crossed our minds. You were funny and sweet. We bonded like long-lost friends. And when I left, you didn't push to kiss me or touch me because you knew my boundaries. But yet, you still proved to be like the other guys. 'Cause 2 days later, you ghosted me. Without explanation. And I questioned myself. Did I do something wrong? Am I not pretty in person? Did I make you think I'd give more, despite what I said? I don't know. I guess I won't know. But I hurt myself in the end. Because I got my hopes up. I fantasized what our connection could grow to be. Imagining scenarios to help me sleep. We met once. I barely knew you. But you said we could be great together. You told me I was beautiful.
In addition, the video to go along with it really brings the scene to life. Voiceover does an excellent job of guiding the story and showing the emotions of the cast. Did you know those actors before you started, or did you just have to, like, find people for this? Yeah, cool. Finding talent is so difficult to, you know, when you're doing these videos, you have to, like, cast actors and everything. It's crazy. Last judge comment, there are a lot of creative camera transitions, and the overall cinematography does an excellent job keeping the viewer interested. Some, a lot of experimental camera moves in there, some of which you've learned here. But, yeah, that is our second runner-up, or first runner-up, sorry. Narrative pieces this time around. Okay, and the next one for the video program, our best of show, is John Mannion. Come on up. Okay. John has crafted for us the Love is Blind short film. It's kind of a short film that transitions into a PSA, starts off pretty dark, but it's got a hopeful turn to the end. So let's take a look. Boop. Gotta find it on this website full of things you've done. Oh, God, where is it? Why'd you do so much stuff? It's like you're a good student or something. All right, let's take a look.
Love. It's blinding. It's an addiction.
Come on, baby girl, just try it.
Come on, yo, just do it. Come on, Cass, just do it. Come on, Cass.
Something that will bleed you dry, put you in positions you never thought you would be in, yet you stay. Right up until you break. You ask how I got here. Love. Addiction. Breaking. How can you fall apart when you love something so much? Hope in your life. Hope in yourself. Hope was my saving grace. Belief in yourself is vital to change. Addiction is a hard challenge to overcome, but it is possible. Today I stand here 1 year sober. Last year was my breaking point. I lost both my loves on the same day, yet I learned to love myself. I was lost and hurting, and I didn't know how to get out, but I found my way. You can as well. Love may be blind, but hope sees through all.
Thank you.
well done. The lighting and composition of the scenes is very effective to enhance the mood. Very good use of props and set decoration. And the use of color and lighting to transition scenes is well done, and the cinematography is well thought out and well executed. And probably the slickest match cut I've ever seen from a student in that last part, where we transition from sad to happy. So, nicely done, John. To thank all of our judges for sitting through a ton of really awesome projects. That was a tough call to pick the best of everything, but all of these projects have something awesome and something to be proud of. And that is about all we've got for you. So that's a portfolio show. I'd like to thank all of you for coming out and supporting our students in showcasing the amazing work that they've been putting all this hard work into. So thank you all so much. Yes, there is snacks over there. Go get them. Mm-hmm. Yes, and please go heckle the students about all their cool projects and go and see things. All of the award winners, if you can meet us up. They done took my mic. There we go. Yeah, can all the award winners come up on stage real quick? We're going to get a group photo.